Welcome back, everybody, to the ugliest sink in the world. Y'all remember this video? Well, I'm back, and it's time to fix it. I'm going to be showing you how to tear out something like this, how to cut the new countertop, not like they did, the proper way, and how to properly install not only the countertop, but the faucet and the sink itself. Stay tuned. This is going to be a wild ride. So this is one of these cases where I've showed you this pry bar before. This can really come in handy. This thing is pretty sharp. It's not like cut yourself sharp, but it's pretty sharp. And it works well for things like this where we've got to pry this off. So if we can get in here, off. Because again, this is a painting tool, you know? So this is perfect for what it is. I'll get right along here and go right along here. That's a little taste of what this thing can do. Utility knife will do it too, but utility knife is so fragile that what you can do is snap the utility knife blade when you're trying to cut something this thick and this tight to it. So this is a little bit better of an option. This or a 5-in-1 tool, something like that. A chisel is too thick. This being thinner for a longer distance, it can get into those places that a chisel can't do.
So I got the sink out, and I put it on some sawhorses to be able to work on it. Now, you can see here this white line. That is silicone. They used a white silicone against the edges, and then all of this, what looks to be like trash or like toilet paper or something that is wadded up, this is the silicone, the clear silicone that's all over the surface. You see I rub at it here, and it just comes right off. Silicone does not stick to stainless steel very well, and so if you just rub at it with your finger or paper towel, it will come right off. It's actually on the inside of the sink here. So this is an extreme example of what not to do, but I do see this done on a lesser level all the time when people are caulking against a sink or against a countertop, where they will overspread the silicone at a very thin level on the surface of whatever they're siliconing in, a shower, whatever. And what happens is that light layer of silicone actually comes off just like this over time. And then water gets underneath what's left, and then you get your black mold that you see against your shower or your sink. But you see here, I'm using a paper towel here to just rub against the surface. I'm not using any abrasives. This is just the paper towel and my fingers to get this off. It doesn't take much, but it will come off with a little elbow grease.